This was originally this was originally number episode 10 of React on Watch Mojo, but I did a one in Dutch, the Black Sabbath songs, and we're doing it now in English because it was requested by MusicFan993. He wanted me to do some bands in English because I did them in Dutch, I believe, half a year ago. So we're gonna do that now in English. So I hope you will enjoy it, and let's watch the video. Do I have some predictions? Yeah, of course. Paranoid, Iron Man are gonna be probably top two. Black Sabbath, self-titled, is gonna be on there. Children of the Grave is a great song. Into the Void, this is a pretty underrated song. IO Warpix is number one, that's my favorite. The live version at Paris, though, you gotta watch that, that is amazing. Yeah, Love Sabbath, they have created heavy metal, so yeah, hope you will enjoy it, and let's see what's on the list. I just wanted to say that, Watch Mojo. Fuck off. Just wanted to name the song.
WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 Black Sabbath songs.
Iron Man?
We've chosen our entries based on a combination of...
No, Warpix. Electric Funeral. Just the entire Paranoid record, man. Such a masterpiece. Yeah, Snowblind. It was already on screen, so. Yeah, Volume 4 is a great record, but it was the decline for Sabbath because they just had released arguably their best records, the first three. And then you got 4 and Sabbath Bloody Sabbath, which is a fan favorite, I believe. It is actually the number one album by Michael Eckerfeld from Opeth, so have fun with that.
This heavy metal number simultaneously expresses Black Sabbath's love and affection for cocaine, while also warning us about the drug's dangers. Despite its slow pace, this 5.5-minute track still holds its own against Sabbath's other work. Thanks in large part to Bill Ward's mastery of the drums and cymbals, which ensures Snowblind is as heavy as the rest of us.
Can't argue with that. Such a classic. This is Supernaut. I wanted to say Supernaut at number 10, but that was Snowblind. This is Supernaut. Great song.
Number 9, Supernaut.
I haven't headbanged on the channel for a while. Maybe I'm gonna throw that back. With Black Sabbath.
But it's so good, it's a long-time fan favorite.
The drum solo. Du, du.
Why?
Du, 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 du.
First off, Supernaut features one of Tony Iommi's best riffs. Secondly,
the breakdown, you gotta listen to the breakdown. Bitch, shut up when the fucking drum solo starts.
It's got Ward at his finest on the skins.
Okay, shut up now.
Ozzy Osbourne then keeps it all together.
Shut the fuck up! They skipped the drum solo. Fucking hell. How to ruin a great song. Fucking hell, Watch Mojo.
Black Sabbath.
Oh, yes. I predicted this one. I love the self-titled Sabbath song. From the self-titled debut album, arguably the best heavy metal album ever, because it was the blueprint, the first ever heavy metal album. Yeah, I love it, really love it. Great record. Listen to Sabbath, man. Listen to Ozzy era, listen to Dio era. You cannot go wrong with, maybe the later era, but I mean, early 70s Black Sabbath. Oh, that is amazing. I got a moment with that because it is so amazing. But you can basically put on any record from the first 6 Sabbath albums, and yeah, I can jizz in my pants because they're such great records.
Their entitled track
I am not exaggerating on that. I'm not. Such great albums.
With its distinctive and menacing vibe, the over 6 minute number was the band's version of a horror movie put to music.
Gotta listen to some Sabbath again. Maybe I'm gonna order some Sabbath.
Because of its popularity,
so amazing.
It quickly became a concert staple and has been covered by multiple bands.
Running down the scale. Sweet Leaf. I'm wondering what this song is about. Master of Reality. Yeah, actually, I've read a Rolling Stone article. Yeah, Rolling Stone, great, right? But I've read that, and Tony Iommi has made public what his favorite records are, and it was a lot of modern albums and the Black Album by Metallica. Some really weird picks, because I don't really expect Tony Iommi to pick modern and a Metallica album, well, the Black Album. And at number one, he chose this record, Master of Reality. And if you didn't know it, it is Tony Iommi's record. So call him egotistical if you want, but it is a great record. But to choose your own record at number one, bit of a strange pick right there. But it is a great record, cannot deny that.
Master of Reality tune features a monster riff and bass-heavy sound that keeps us addicted all the way through.
The fuck, Ozzy? I mean, Ozzy is a legend, but he is so fucking childish. But that is a good thing. He never aged. That is a good thing. He always is a little kid on stage, and that is a good thing. Never grow old. That is the message Ozzy Osbourne delivers you. Heaven and Hell?
Six. Heaven and Hell.
Classic.
It may be the only track on our list with vocalist Ronnie James Dio.
Oh, really? Yeah, it is kind of his best song, but I expected Neil Nice to be on there as well. I mean, I love the first six, but you gotta have some Heaven and Hell on there. Great record as well.
With its badass guitar solo and bass line, the Iommi penned piece delves into the age-old exploration between good and evil. More fantastic experienced live as new lyrics and more music are often added.
And I love that self-titled debut album, man. Love it.
I-N-I-B. This song's title was an acronym for the words Nativity in Black.
That is a possibility.
With Geezer Butler later claimed it described Ward's pen-nib-shaped facial hair. Either way, NIB is another Sabbath track about the devil, but it's got a twist. Lucifer falls in love. Also notable as Butler's opening bass solo and the song's incorporation of blues, hard rock, and psychedelic rock to its heavy metal sound.
That solo. Children of the Grave, yeah. I just love Master of Reality, man. Arguably the best record.
Thank you.
Sean's anti-war. Not anything from Paranoid yet. Children of the Grave is far from being a peaceful sounding track.
In fact, it's more accurate to say that it stops a lot thanks to Ozzy's characteristic vocals, Iommi's big bad riffs, and Ward's captivating drumming.
Yeah, I realize yet that everything is from the first four records and one Heaven and Hell track, so that only proves how, how much they have fallen from grace, because they're not the best band anymore. They were actually, I believe they were on the lists. That was a pretty interesting list. The top 10 bands that shouldn't write any music anymore, new music. And Sabbath was on number 10, so yeah, I agree with that, but they have quit it now, so they're not eligible for the list anymore, so there we are. Maybe they watched the video and thought to themselves, oh, alright, we're gonna quit. Maybe, who knows. All Warpix, yes. Best Sabbath song ever.
Number 3, Warpix.
Arguably the best heavy metal song of all time.
This song was transformed from one about a satanic festival to an anti-war piece, which was particularly relevant considering what was going on in Vietnam at the time. With its memorable guitar solo, the use of an air raid siren, and Osborne's angst-filled vocals, War Pigs is a poignant number lasting almost 8 minutes. Thanks to its anthemic nature, it's also often played in concert.
Iron Man, yeah.
Number 2, Iron Man.
I prefer War Pigs, but Iron Man, one of their most popular, so yeah, Watch Mojo picks that, so big surprise there. That intro is epic though.
Ironclad riff, vocal effects, and futuristic tone, the song peaked within the Billboard Hot 100's Top 60. Further cementing its place as a Black Sabbath classic, the live rendition of Iron Man won a Grammy almost 3 decades later. Also earned newfound popularity when the Marvel superhero movie franchise shot to success in 2008.
Don't mention that shit with this legendary act, please.
Before we unveil our
they don't even credit it in the movie, don't they? Headless Cross from self-titled. Ta-da. Not the biggest fan of Tony Martin era, but that is a good album. Verve Boots from Paranoid. Bloody Sabbath from self-titled. Yeah, I love that record. Unfortunately, there wasn't anything from that record on there, but... Well, it is Watch Mojo, so they only go for most popular, so there we go. Sitting on the Universe from Sabotage, great record as well. The last great one, arguably, but there we are, with Ozzy. The Wizard from self-titled. Sign of the Southern Cross from Mob Rules. Paranoid. Yeah, it is an obvious choice, but it is obvious for a reason.
Needing one more more song to complete their sophomore effort, Sabbath originally thought this would be a filler tune. But once Iommi conceived of its dynamic riff, and Butler added his tormented lyrics, Paranoid became the new title track and the album's first single to be released.
Can you help me occupy my brain?
Oh, yeah. Rock number with elements of proto-punk that charted within the UK top 5. Because Paranoid's heavy metal sound was unlike anything heard before, it set the blueprint for the genre and countless subgenres thereafter.
Yeah, but Sabbath started it, and that is what counts.
Do you agree with our list? What's your favorite Black Sabbath song? New top 10s published daily. Be sure to subscribe to WatchMojo.com.
Yeah, classic acts, love them. Yeah, a lot of from the first four records. Unfortunately, nothing from Sabbath and Sabotage, one honorable mention, but that doesn't really count. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Let me know what are your favorite Black Sabbath songs. Let me know what are your favorite albums. Let's check out the comments for a bit, but I don't think they're really interesting. Warpix, I love Warpix, I'm done. Yeah, I love Warpix as well. Oh, come on, Sabbath is one of their greatest tracks. I agree, that is a great track, love it. Not even a mention for Into the Void. I mentioned that is a great song. Dio is better than Ozzy. But, with three T's, fair game. Black Sabbath with Ozzy is better than Black Sabbath with Dio. Ow, my hand. Yeah, I understand what he means. He means that Dio is the better singer. But Ozzy with Black Sabbath is better because Ozzy is on the better albums. Yeah, but I think, yeah, what he says is right. Black Sabbath, Ozzy with Black Sabbath is better, the lineup, but Dio's singing ability, his vocal range is better than Ozzy's. I agree with that. Good comments. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Let me know what are your favorite songs by Black Sabbath, your favorite albums by them. Let me know it in the comments, and yeah, peace out and enjoy the videos. Enjoy Black Sabbath. Didn't know why I said peace out, but just enjoy Black Sabbath. They invented heavy metal. I mean, who can say that? I invented the genre. I invented a genre. I mean, almost nobody can say that except for Black Sabbath. And that is why they are so legendary.